Who knows what evil lurks in the heart of games? The Shadows knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadows Knows, and I'm back, finally, with another Let's Compare video. Tonight I compare the game Rock'n'Roll Racing on the Sega Mega Drive, or Sega Genesis, and the Super Nintendo. And I start with the Mega Drive, and let's see how this works out. I think I still have a little trouble with my Mega Everdrive. I'm not quite sure if it's broken, but probably it is, so maybe the game may glitch a little. Yeah, and wrong button. And I already fired my cannon, great. But you can already hear what's so great, or what is great about this game. It's the music. The racers are pretty boring, but the music is awesome. Scrolling is not smooth at all, and I'm wondering if this is because I'm playing it on a European system, on a PAL system, and not on an American or Japanese system. And why does the music stop always, anytime this guy shouts? But you can turn everything on and off, the music, the annoying or not annoying voice, and the sound effects. And I hope I don't get into too much trouble for the music. But since the music is probably the only exceptional with this game, I have to let it play. Shit, I'm about to explode. No! Wah! I have to pick up and power up. Yeah. Damn, missed both. It's not a bad game. Nothing exceptional besides the music. And it's really annoying that the music stops anytime the race announcer has something to say. And so far the game doesn't glitch, that's not bad. I played it a couple of times before, and it glitched a lot. As I said, I still have some problems with my Mega Everdrive. I hope I don't have to send it back. Yeah, but I think that's the last lap on the on the Mega Drive. And I think there are 5 tunes in this game. 5 on the Mega Drive and 4 on the Super Nintendo. Or 6 on the Mega Drive and 5 on the Super Nintendo. The Super Nintendo version doesn't get Radar Love. So, but let's see. Okay, back with the Super Nintendo version. Let's see how it compares. Again, a new game. Rookie. To make it really easy. And I think this is a little brighter than the Genesis. Same guy. Same car, same color. But I think you can already hear music is much, much nicer. And again, got the wrong button. I think the graphics looks a little bit nicer, a little bit more colors, but movement scrolling is as jerky as on the Mega Drive. But the music stands out. Yes, graphics definitely more colorful. Music and sound. Music doesn't stop for the race announcer. That's awesome. Yeah, shoulder buttons also. Also steer the car. Don't know why, but generally I do prefer the Genesis or Mega Drive gamepad over the Super Nintendo gamepad, especially the buttons. I like the bigger buttons on the standard Mega Drive gamepad much more than the four tiny buttons on the Nintendo one. And they are shaped differently. One of them are convex and the other ones are concave. And since I'm not quite sure which one is which, I don't tell you which, if the Nintendo one is convex or concave. But they are different. And I find the gamepad on the Mega Drive much more comfortable than on the Nintendo. Yeah, let the carnage begin. And if I press the right button, the correct button, which coincidentally is the right button, not the right shoulder button, not the right button on the button field, or how you would call it. No, it's not the right button, it's a lower button, but yeah, if you press the right button, you get a better start than if you press the wrong button. And you don't waste your one shot of ammo. And yeah, what else is to say? Besides that the music is much better on the Nintendo. Graphics is more colorful on the Nintendo. Music doesn't stop for the race announcer, which is awesome. Yeah, and since the Nintendo has one button more. Yeah. You have this laser gun, one shot. You have those, which also will kill your car, so be very careful and remember where you put them. And you can jump once. And yeah, there are the four buttons on the Nintendo controller. On the Mega Drive, you simply have to double tap the ESC. They also disturb your own car. On the Mega Drive, you have to double tap the accelerator button to jump. No big deal. Still like the Mega Drive pad more, but the music is much better on the Nintendo. Gameplay is basically the same, but yeah, you don't play the game for the game, you play the game for the music, at least I do. And yeah, there's also an upgrade system. You get money if you win the race. You can get a better engine. Yeah, more ammo. Better jumping, better cannon, I think. Better tires, better armor. Yeah. You can upgrade to another league, to the next level. You can buy a new car. You have an option screen. As said, you can turn music on off, sound on off. And the announcer on off, Larry. And you can write down the password, which is pretty short. I like that. To continue playing. Oops. Exit, and of course you can buy another car if you have enough money. I don't, and I don't know if there are any more cars, but yeah, that's Rock and Roll Racing on the 16-bit consoles. So yeah, you can expect me to include the console versions into my Let's Compare videos. And I don't shift to consoles completely. Yeah, I hope you liked my return video, and thanks for watching.